Hey there, I'm Alex. Let's play the mind, shall we? Back in 1970, composer Alvin Lucier wrote a piece called I Am Sitting in a Room. It starts with a performer sitting in a closed space, making a recording of himself talking. Then a second recording is made by playing back the previous one within the same space. Then a third recording is made the same way, then a fourth one, and a fifth one, and so on until the final playback sounds something like acoustic sludge.
I am sitting in a room different from the one you are in now.
I am recording the sound of my speaking voice, and I will play it back into the room again and again.
Resonant frequencies. Those are the sounds that gradually get louder with every playback, and the remaining sounds simply get weaker and die off. It all has to do with how the sounds bounce around the room and either gain or lose strength depending on the echoes produced. You can think of a room as being a strainer in which all the sounds are poured, and the looping process is kind of like shaking the strainer in order to separate some of the sounds from all the other ones. And different rooms, like different strainers, give different results. It's the same principle of acoustic resonance behind this. A bottle is, in fact, a tiny little room, and the space that's inside follows the same acoustic principles as any other closed space. RimstarOrg has made a detailed video explaining the physics behind this phenomenon, and Nick Moore on his channel, by using a slow motion camera and smoke, he reveals how the airflow behaves across a bottle opening. I guess we should thank Alvin Lucier for introducing us to acoustic resonance. In a way, we can say that his music resonated with us. But that wasn't his intended purpose. Alvin Lucier was someone who stuttered, and he used acoustic resonance as a way to smooth out his speech.
I regard this activity as a way to smooth out any irregularities my speech might have.
DAF. Delayed auditory feedback. That's a different way of using sound in order to smooth out stuttering. It works by making someone listen to their own voice through earphones, but with a slight delay. In people who stutter, this stimulates parts of the brain involved in speech production, but in non-stuttering individuals, this actually has a completely opposite effect.
Okay. You have to keep looking at my nose. I didn't take a picture.
Slow down a little bit.
DAF can really be awesome for someone who stutters, but the help it offers is only temporary at best. Still, electronic fluency devices and smartphone apps which implement DAF can still be helpful for some individuals during short-term interactions, like phone calls or job interviews. The most widespread definition of stuttering comes from the World Health Organization. It's a vague definition, but it contains one crucial element. During a stuttering moment, the individual knows exactly the words to say, but it's the action of expressing them that has trouble getting through. Repetition happens when one single sound or a whole syllable gets repeated. Prolongation is when a sound is held out for some time, but the mouth, lips, and tongue have stopped moving. And blocking happens when speech is stopped altogether, the whole speaking process gets jammed. And these are just a few of the disfluencies associated with stuttering. Phonologists once thought that the problem was with the body itself or with the connections between the brain and the body, but recent findings show that the problem lies within the brain itself. Researchers found that the blood flow to the Broca area is significantly reduced in people who stutter, and the more severe the stutter, the less the blood perfusion. These recent findings on what causes stuttering are a huge step towards finding a suitable treatment. It's estimated that around 70 million people across the world are affected by this condition. Unfortunately, the negative attitudes towards stuttering are still very present across all cultures and societies, and for someone who stutters, these attitudes can really be hurtful. The Stuttering Foundation has put together 6 tips for speaking with someone who stutters. These guidelines are definitely helpful, and what's even more important to remember is to behave like any decent human being would, with patience, respect, and empathy. That's all for now. Thanks for being here.